Oh, Glenn, these last couple of weeks have been so wonderful. I feel incredibly close to you already. And it's not just because you're a prestigious surgeon with social position, a jag, and a mansion full of toadying servants. My sweet, it's because you make me laugh.
You know, Sharon, the last couple of weeks have been great for me, too.
Dare we dream of a future together?
Hi, Sharon. I didn't feel like doing laundry, so I thought I'd come over and borrow some of Larry's underpants. I don't think he'll mind since he's not around anymore. I sure hope he has boxer shorts, because those tight jockeys really kind of cramp my style, if you know what I mean. I think you do. Hey, who the hell are you?
Dr. Glenn Morris.
And you are?
An idiot. Leaving.
Oh, a doctor, huh? Oh. Hmm. So, what, does she have that elephant man thing and you didn't want to bring her down to the hospital, frighten the other patients?
Yeah. Sharon and I have been seeing each other.
Oh, my God, Sharon. You have the nerve to be living out your filthy little sex fantasies when your husband's dear corpse isn't even cold in the ground? I could pass a kidney right here on the floor.
Corpse? I thought you said that Larry had disappeared.
He did, of course. And this is the jackass who drove him off.
Well, that's what she'd like people to think. But the truth would make a street-hardened homicide dick drop to his knees and vomit like a choir girl.
You're insinuating that she killed her husband? I'm sorry, but I have a very hard time believing that this sweet little thing is capable of violence.
Thank you, darling.
Now get out! You on fire and put it out with an axe!
Gee, she is a little scary.
Well, only if you find the words mysterious stench in the crawl space scary. You never know when she's gonna blow, and boy, if she's got a motive, well, you can just kiss your well-groomed butt goodbye. I just pray you're not a wealthy man.
Look, Sharon, I gotta run. I'll call you sometime. Oh, yeah, tidbit of trivia for you. You know that fence around my mansion? That's electric.
Jeez, what a jerk. You're better off alone and celibate until Larry finishes whoring around and comes back home.
Oh, Chris, I've always tried to control myself with you because, after all, you were Larry's best friend. But now that Larry isn't around anymore, I see no reason at all to continue holding back.
Sharon, please, I don't think you've ever been holding back.
Man, she was holding back.
Hey, what is it?
Tomorrow night to show Glenn off to two of my old sorority sisters. I finally snagged the perfect man after the humiliation of losing Larry, and all I wanted to do was to watch my two dearest friends in the world slobber with envy.
Andy Taylor, you listen to your Aunt Bee. That boy hopefully needs a mother.
Oh. Oh, I've got to get another date by tomorrow night. But no, I promised them Glenn. Rich, spineless, easily dominated Glenn. I've got to get a Glenn impersonator. I know what stupid sap would go along with a plan like that. Oh, no, not him. No, anyone but him. Maybe if I just put one of Larry's suits on the dog. Maybe he wouldn't be so bad after all. know, it might work if I really load their drinks. They just might go crazy. Chris.
What? Who?
Come on.
When? Ow. Wow.
Yes.
Ow.
I've decided to let you live. On one condition. Mm-hmm. That you pose as Glenn at my dinner party tomorrow night.
Get real, Sharon. Come on.
So what time is your lovely soiree?
Sharon, I don't know about Larry's suit here. Hey, it's a little tight in the butt.
Oh, please, Chris. Don't expend all your charm before the company arrives.
Hey. Now that's funny. You know, in all the times I've been coming over here, I never realized you had one of those handy walk-in meat lockers. I always thought that was just a powder room.
Oh, good, that must be them. Oh, time enough for one more threat. Chris, if you blow this, my last beating will seem like a sweet memory.
Sharon! Oh,
it's so good to see you. Oh, you look so beautiful.
You too.
No, welcome. Come in. Are you? Everyone, I'd like you to meet Dr. Glenn Morris.
Ladies, Sharon has told me so much about you two. You know, I practically feel like I'm one of you. Not that I'm wearing anything frilly underneath the suit, you understand. Come on, honey. Come on over here and fork over some of that sweet stuff. Come on, here we go. All right, hold on to your padded bra. I'm not playing favorites. You two. Here we go.
Why don't we all just sit down, shall we?
Oh, please. Yeah. All right, everybody. Let's all go over here. Okay, party, yeah.
Sharon, we were so sorry to hear about Larry.
Thank you, dear. But, you know, I'm really getting over it quite well, thanks to Glenn.
Oh, gee, honey. Oh, man. That goes triple for me, milk dud ears.
Why do I suddenly have a craving for nougat?
That's wonderful.
So, Glenn, Sharon tells us you're a micro-neurosurgeon.
So what are you saying, I'm not one? Or that I don't even know what one is? All right, well, gnaw on this bud, okay? A micro... whatchama... who's it? There's a guy who operates on brains, okay? And when it comes to that, I am King Hot Pants. In fact, I could take this pen right here, and I could stick it in your ear, and with just a slight manipulation, I could make you jump up, drop your trousers, and do an embarrassing little poodle hop. And I should just back off, Mr. Joe College Nazi frat boy. Ugh. I also invented gum.
I'm sorry, but chewing gum has been around for hundreds of years.
Oh, yeah, right, honey, and the pilgrims came over on the space shuttle. Quick, somebody get her a drink before she whips out her flask.
The important thing is that the two of you are happy together.
Mm. Oh, gee, hey, you hit the nail on the head there. Well, I have never been so content in my life. And you're talking to a guy who's slept with every high-priced hooker in the state. But not one of them holds a candle to this lady right here. No, I'm not saying she's a whore or anything, uh-huh. Don't get me wrong. But, you know, if she ever decided she wanted to be one, you know, the lines would just be around the block.
Yeah, no, help me get something out of the meat locker, please. Excuse us.
Oh, yeah, all right. Yeah, sure. I almost forgot. It's been almost an hour. Time to stoke the old love furnace, if you know what I mean. Hey, folks, if you hear a zipper sound coming from in here, that would be my zipper. Jeez, you guys eat a lot of meat. Your kids must have a cholesterol level of an 80-year-old truck driver. Now, Sharon, I'm sensing a little hostility here.
Chris, we are going back out there. And if you so much as mention sex again, you are going to be hanging from one of these.
Yes, Sharon. Okay. Hey, how do you get this thing open?
Oh, please. God, I must have slammed it too hard.
All right, girlie, step aside. Let a full-grown boy handle this.
We're gonna die! We're gonna die! Help! Help!
Help! My God! Glenn wasn't joking. They're going at it like a couple of running warthogs. This is the height of rudeness. You'd never catch us having sex in our meat locker when we have company over. We're leaving. Us too. Well, at least Sharon didn't find out you're just some jerk pretending to be my boyfriend because my husband left me.
All right, don't worry. I'm sure they'll be here in a couple of seconds. Listen, in the meantime, could I borrow your sweater? Why won't they let us out? It's because I'm 1/16th Lakota Sioux Indian, isn't it? You racist bastards!
What if they get tired of waiting and went home?
Wait a second. We don't need them at all.
What?
I hold in my hand the solution to our little dilemma.
What? Paperclip?
Well, to the untrained eye, perhaps. But to the dutiful watcher of TV's MacGyver, it's a veritable super deluxe toolkit from Sears. And with it, I shall loose us from this, our watery graves.
You'd be lucky if you could get that to hold paper together.
All right, sister, just stand back and eat my dust. Or whatever residue I may leave.
You actually did!
Whoa, not so fast. I think a certain somebody owes a certain dashing hero an apology.
I'm not apologizing to you.
Oh, yeah, right, you're not. Okay, hold on one second.
What?
There, yeah, no, it's closed. Yeah, and that's gonna stay closed until I hear an apology. And it better be from the heart.
Well, I'm sorry I thought you couldn't open it, you fat, brain-dead ass!
Fine, now, is that so difficult? Jeez. Now it would be my honor to rescue you, me fair lady, me damsel fine. Could I have another paperclip, please?
What are you talking about, another paperclip? What happened to the one you just had?
Well, it was used. I threw it out.
To rescue us. We are doomed.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God, you're right.
No.
And if we're stuck in here for minutes on end, we could starve to death.
Chris, look around you and tell me what you see.
Oh, my God. Oh, the bodies of all those who have gone before us.
Imbecile! We are not going to starve to death. We are going to freeze to death.
Oh, jeez, well, that's a relief. Well, then all we need is a big, freshly killed elephant to crawl up inside of and be warm and cozy as two bugs in a rug and a stomach. So where's the elephant?
There is no elephant.
Not even in the zoo? Well, there's no reason to go on living.
Yes, there are plenty of elephants in the zoo.
Oh, good. Well, then we got to get out of here. Hey, you know what? I have an idea.
What?
We could probably share each other's body heat if we were hugged and snuggled together.
I'd rather be chiseled out of here with an ice pick.
Sharon, believe me, I'm not looking to get any pleasure out of this. I mean, I don't want a cheap sexual thrill or anything. I just think it's our best chance for survival, that's all.
Actually, you're probably right about that.
Yeah, I am. Sure. There's a spot right down here. Let me say we cuddle up right here. What's wrong with you? I was just sighing from relief. Jeez, would you stop being such a prudy-prude prudence and come to pop like a dog?
Well, it's not so bad. It's rather like being engulfed by a big gooey compost heap.
Enjoy.
Sharon? Sharon? I was so disgusted by your inexcusable behavior that I forgot my purse.
Chris, I think I hear voices.
Oh, I get that a lot. Just try pounding on the side of your head. They'll go away.
I think there might be someone out there.
Really?
Yeah.
Hey. Filthy scum. They have stamina, though.
I guess I was mistaken. Oh. My mind must be playing tricks on me. Chris, we've got to keep talking, or else we may slip into a complete hypothermic delirium.
Wow, a whole new kind of delirium. And I thought I had tried them all.
I can feel my arms and legs at all anymore. I think that maybe we are actually going to die in here. Oh. But before we do, there's something I want to get off my chest.
You know, I pray you are talking about your bra. Otherwise, you are the worst kind of tease.
But I want to say, Chris, that I don't think you are such a flabby, bald, asinine troll.
Really?
Well, you are a little on the flabby and bald side. Let's face it, you are pretty damn asinine. Technically, I think you're too tall to be a troll.
Wow. Sharon, I don't know what to say. But you know, as long as we're pouring our hearts out here, I think you should know that even though I've always considered you an evil, castrating she creature from hell, I've also always found you quite shapely. You see, I too am not without my tender side.
Suddenly, I don't find you all that unattractive. I mean, with our faces this close together and everything, you could be almost anyone.
go on and say it, then. You want me. You crave my body. You crave it like a pearl diver craves Fluffer Nutter.
I know it's probably the hypothermic delirium, but God help me, I actually want you.
Well, then, let's go out with a bang and not a whimper. Or if we do it right, both.
I love you, Sharon.
I love you, Chris. I think I've actually loved you. From the first moment, I hated you. Say something romantic.
Certain sauces give me a rash.
Oh, you're special, special man.
Take me now. But be gentle. Wow. Unless you like it rough, then consider me your rag doll, baby.
I love it.
Hey, everybody. Chris said I could come to the party as long as I called him Glenn. Boy, I've been to some dull shindigs, but this hardly seems worth crashing. Oh, well, nothing tastes sweeter than free grub. Hey! I got one of those walk-in living room meat lockers that are all the rage. Maybe I'll just get a few choice cuts to go. Jackpot! Jeez, it's a kid and that Potter wench. They're in real trouble. Hell, they can wait. It's not like they're gonna spoil or anything.
Oh, Mommy. Mommy, it's so good to feel your whiskers again.
Kid, you're alive. Thank God. I hate filling out those coroner statements.
Jeez, Gus. How long have I been frozen?
I don't know, a couple hours maybe.
A couple of hours? Oh, geez, this is like that Byron Allen movie, Sleeper. I'll have to adjust to a whole new futuristic world.
Kid, I think we better pop your head into the microwave for a few minutes.
Oh. What? Sharon! Sharon, my love lozenge! You're alive!
Your love? Mm. Oh, God, I'm dead. And hell is even worse than I expected it to be.
No, honey, don't you remember?
What?
We're star-crossed lovers now. Soulmates, which no man, beast, or podiatrist can ever wrench asunder.
The minute I know we kissed, but that is all.
Jeez, are you kidding? Come on, baby, we did it all. Yeah.
You are an animal.
I still think I have one of your cheap fake fingernails embedded in my back.
Way to go, kid. I can't wait to hear all the gory details.
I got them.
This is not happening.
I think what I'm going to do is go home, pack up some of my festering laundry and just a few baubles and bring them over here so we can start our blissful cohabitation together. Fire of my loins. Oh, and goodbye, Chris Jr. I sure hope you're not fat.
Excuse me. I have to go scrub my entire body with steel wool now. And then blow my brains out.
Boy, what a meal. I can't believe you actually won the national meat lotto. You must have the luck of the Swedish.
You're the lucky one, kid, getting to sleep with that Hellcat Sharon.
Oh. You know what, Gus? We never actually slept together. I just let her think we did. It was one of my cruel but very funny jokes. Aren't I a scamp?
I heard that, scum. Prepare to die. Ow!
Okay. Oh, that's the stomach. Ah, there go the ears.